ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Frank Sinatra!
It's time for you. It's time for you. I'm telling you that dreams come true. Come on, baby, it's time, time, time. It's time for you.
Thank you very much. You're marvelous. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. This is Francis Albert reminding you that it is time. It's time that for all of us to start buying and driving American cars. Recently, I visited the Motor City, and I have to be quite honest with you that I did not like what I saw. Kabish? Thousands and thousands of beautiful guys and chicks out of work because you are not buying American cars. Now, I'd like you to meet one of the guys that America forgot. If you'd be so kind, please welcome from the United Auto Workers of America, Jerry Hemphill, ladies and gentlemen. It's very nice to have you here, Jerry. Speak.
Thank you. Good to be here, Frank. Well, Frank, I used to work for Chrysler, and I was installing power seat assemblies until I got laid off. Well, it's bad enough for me and my old lady, you know, but it's hard to see the kids staying at home just starving.
You hear that, America? Because you do not care enough to drive and buy American cars.
That's right, Frank. I'll tell you, these people, they just build their cars out of cheap, thin aluminum. I got something to show you here, Frank.
We're talking foreign labor here. We're talking Japs, ladies and gentlemen.
It's a Japanese beer can right here, Fred. Now, you see how they're cheap, thin aluminum. Now, your American cars are built solid, like a J.C. Higgins bowling ball. You follow me, Frank?
I got you, Jerry.
You just thank God your family wasn't in here.
Thank you very much. Jerry Hemphill, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much, Jerry. O'Reilly. Beautiful. Thank you so much. And now I'd like viewers to meet someone that wasn't so lucky, ladies and gentlemen. Tell us your name, sweetheart.
Melissa.
Melissa, tell the people your story.
Well, my dad got one of those cheap Japanese cars, you know, and we were going to my grandmother's house, you know, for dinner, and my dad ran into this cow, and he hurt the cow real bad, and I had to go to the hospital. And now I can't play with the other children.
God bless you, sweetheart.
And now I can't even do that.
Okay, America, you want another reason to stop buying Jap cars? Huh? I got 1,000 reasons, like the rows upon rows of simple white crosses that mark the graves at Arlington National Cemetery. I take you back to December 7th, 1941, and the story of a young gunner aboard the USS Arizona. Ladies and gentlemen, it is indeed my honor to introduce to you Harold Duffy, U.S. Navy, retired. Okay, Chief, tell them how it happened.
Well, I remember I was playing the harmonic and laughing up with some of my buddies aboard the USS Arizona, and then from out of nowhere came them Jap planes, their machine guns spitting death. I lost my best buddy that day, Frank.
I know what you mean. When we were shooting from here to eternity, I had to leave the set every day because of the tears in my eyes.
Bless you, Frank. Well, you think of that the next time you see a friend or neighbor driving one of them Japmobiles, you tell them that the same tuna heads that put together the assembly of that darn thing are probably the same people who are responsible for jamming bamboo shoots under these fingernails.
Ouch.
Yeah, well, who can understand the Oriental mind, Frank? I tell you, you're talking about people who build their houses out of paper. People who build their, they call their planes zeros. They call their boats junks.
Wait, for the record, Chief, I think the junks are Chinese, not Japanese.
What's the difference? You remember on Bonanza, whenever there was a range war, where the hell was Hop Sing anyway, huh? And you're buying cars from people that eat raw fish. Think of that. How would you like to open the glove compartment of your Honda and find one of these in there?
Thank you very much. Harold Duffy, ladies and gentlemen, U.S. Navy retired from the USS Arizona. Thank you, Harold Duffy. After hearing all these beautiful people speak tonight, there is only one thing I can say. Let's strive for America. Strive for America. Each time I see those dots and Z's, I want to punch out a Japanese. Go to hell, Toyota. Drop dead Subaru. Let's ride for America. Take pride in America. Let's drive for America. Old red, I'm talking white and a blue.